Hornet was one of those in the paradigm whom most of his compatriots looked down upon, for he had no special abilities like the rest of them. Not a superhuman, just a regular guy who can be regarded as an adrenaline junkie. He was regarded as a mere mortal walking among gods, in which some of the members of the paradigm questioned his usefulness. But the truth is that the Hornet was more than just a vigilante. In fact, he was psychologically strategic, had great martial arts skills, great mental awareness, and had an instinct of a bat, which was one of the main reasons the Plutonian asked him to join the paradigm. And no one dare questioned the Plutonian's decision. You must know that the Hornet was the survivor's idol, in whom he worships and adores, mainly because he was just a man with no special powers to back him up, just strategy and skills, standing shoulder to shoulder with people with special powers to fight evil people with special powers. To him, that was impressive. Now remember that Cupid was debating with the survivor over the elimination of the Plutonian, and he let him know that his mentor, the Hornet, agreed with him that ending the life of the Plutonian wasn't the solution. Now Kaidan was about to spill the good news about the possibility of Skylar being alive, but Cupid told her to hold the good news for now. Well, before the Plutonian ended the life of the Hornet and his family, for they were his first victims when he went bonkers, the Hornet sent an encoded transmission to Cupid, strictly warning him to listen to the recording outside airspace. And this recording was recorded 6 weeks before the Plutonian went AWOL. In the holographic recording, the Hornet was shaken and terrified, in tears and paranoid. He somehow knew that the Plutonian was going to kill him, but even in despair, he believed there is still hope. With the Plutonian, the Hornet had always been wary of him. No one ever questioned the Plutonian's integrity, sincerity, or honesty. His emotions have been unpredictable. You can't, most of the time, tell if he was happy, sad, or angry. And with this, made a lot of them in the group walk on eggshells around him, for no one knows what might upset him. In fact, he never gets upset. That's the problem. For this reason, it made the Hornet a bit more guarded and mentally aware of his surrounding, for among the members of the paradigm, he was the only member without superpowers. Not that it bothered him, just that he had to be safe, but his instinct or paranoia about the Plutonian made him cautious of not overstepping his boundaries. The truth is that on the surface, they were very close, much like best friends. In fact, the Hornet sometimes talk about his family to him without mentioning their names. But on this particular day, when they were playing cards, the Plutonian asked about his wife Donna. It wasn't him asking about his wife that bothered him, it's the fact that the Plutonian mentioned her by name shook the reaction in him that the Plutonian was secretly spying on each members of the paradigm, for he never told him the name of his wife or his daughter. In his paranoia or instinct, the Hornet believed it was a matter of time before the most powerful and strongest man in the universe lose his temper. For the fallacy among them is that the Plutonian is all good and has no darkness. Not because he had a bad temper, far from it. In fact, the Plutonian is the most mild-mannered individual you will ever come across, even at the worst of times. But imagine all that pressure putting the world on his shoulders. The pressure he is under when saving the world. He barely rests. He is either here or there, saving lives and defending the earth from invasion and destruction. And before anyone could be aware or suspicious of the Plutonian going rogue, the Hornet saw it coming. For when no one was looking, especially when one of their mission goes southward, he can see a tiny expression of the Plutonian's bitterness and resentment towards failure. And then he sighs and holds back his emotions. Hornet was grateful to Cupid for taking him to places he never thought he could ever step on, like walking on the moon, traveling through different dimensions, passing through the cosmos, and visiting Earth-like planets with unusual and great civilization. I mean, the Hornet saw things he could ever imagine. At first, it was scary, but as time goes by, he got used to it. A watch on Cupid's wrist blipped, sounding the alert, which distracted both Kaidan and Survivor, but he told them to continue listening to the recording. Terrified and scared to death, Modeus, whom inhabits the body of Samsara, knew this might be the end of him, for no one fools the Plutonian, especially this Plutonian, since he had gone rogue. But to Modeus' astonishment, the Plutonian didn't seem or come across mad or angry. In fact, he was more understanding and was impressed with Modeus' geniosity, in which he asked the Plutonian when did he found out that he wasn't Samsara. And the Plutonian replied him, from the beginning he knew the pattern in which he talks and communicates in an emotionless flow, and that he knows the damage he did to Samsara, for he can never heal himself. But he understood why Modeus possessed the body of Samsara. It is because he wanted to get close to him, to be his equal, and when he needs someone to turn to, it would be him. Modeus, whom inhabits the body of Samsara, expressed to the Plutonian that he was scared and afraid, in which the Plutonian assured him that no harm will ever come to him, for he is not seeking for vengeance, making Modeus, whom inhabits the body of Samsara, very comfortable. But before he knew what was happening, the Plutonian blasted his face with his laser fiery beam as he scuttered off in pain, screaming as the Plutonian watched in excitement, holding the sapphire of Ishwa. Well, 3 years ago, before this time, there was an invasion by an alien race from light years away from Earth called Vespa soldiers. And these invaders were no ordinary invaders. In fact, before they attacked, they made sure they studied each and anyone with superpowers. So when they attacked, it became a tedious war for the paradigm, and for human lives were being lost daily, and it was doing damage to Earth. The Hornet, whom all had regarded as dead weight except the Plutonian and Cupid, who think otherwise, came up with the idea of stealthily sneaking into the ship of the Vespa soldiers while the rest of them fight them as a distraction at the battlefront. But Cupid objected to the idea, for it was too risky and he believes that Hornet might lose his life. It was suicide. The Hornet, whom was adamant, insisted and convinced Cupid that he should give him his teleportation device, the quantum jumper, so he can teleport himself into the ship while they face the Vespa soldiers at the battlefront, in which he will be connected to Gazer through his PSI link, which will feed Cupid information when he is inside the Vespa ship. Now, when Hornet got into the Vespa ship, Gazer, whom was linked with the Hornet, was hit by one of the Vespa soldiers, in which disrupted the link between them, and Hornet was on his own with without outside guidance. To make things worse for the Hornet, he was captured by the Vespa soldiers and was taken to their leader. When he got to the leader of the Vespa soldiers, the leader told him that they were star travelers from light years away from Earth, and that planet Earth was the first adequate planet they come across, and made it clear to the Hornet that they were going nowhere, that his soldiers will stop at nothing to overrun Earth for their needs, and they are prepared to fight this war to the finish till eternity. And in all honesty, it was an endless war, for no side was winning and people were dying due to collateral damage. Moreover, the Vespa soldiers were kidnapping and using babies to create their offsprings. Now, the Hornet had no way out of this, for he was stuck with the Vespa soldiers, so he tried to make a deal. But before he made a deal with them, he asked the Vespa soldiers for a very strange favor, which was to help subjugate and capture the Plutonian if he ever goes rogue and turn against the people of Earth, and they can do as they please with him. This request shocked the leader of the Vespa, for he wondered what sort of mindset is this, for humans are a bit complicated, and this mannerism was alien to the aliens. For the leader of the Vesper soldiers wondered how he can sell out one of his own whom is fighting on their sides. For in such, there was no honor. The leader of the Vesper soldiers was angry at the Hornet because he hadn't offered anything tangible, for he thinks the Hornet is baiting them for time. Then the Hornet offered to them Cupid's teleportation device, the quantum jumper, in which will help them travel faster, for their spaceship was gigantic and consumed a lot of fuel. But if they can intelligently upgrade the quantum jumper, they wouldn't need fuel to travel anymore. Now the Vesper soldiers were intrigued and impressed with the quantum jumper. As vast in knowledge and advanced in technology as they were, to them the quantum jumper was one of a kind. It was beyond their intellectual faculty. But to the Hornet's astonishment, they rejected the teleportation device, for it was the least of their ambition at the moment. But at this point, it comes across that the Hornet had his own ambition and agenda, which was different from what he discussed with Cupid and the rest of the team. Now remember him thanking Cupid for taking him to places he can never imagine, especially the Earth-like planets. Well, the Hornet made a deal with the Vesper soldiers that he will send them exact transport coordination of Earth-like planets if they promise to leave planet Earth alone and come to their rescue whenever the Plutonian goes rogue. The leader of the Vesper soldiers held a meeting with his associates and they agreed to the deal, and without any fuss, they left peacefully, in which surprised everyone, especially those who looked down their nose at the Hornet. He became the hero of the day. And when Cupid and the Plutonian asked him how he made the Vesper depart peacefully, he gave them an irrelevant answer. As he had promised, behind the back of everyone in the group, he began to send the Vesper soldiers the exact transport coordinates of Earth-like planets in the excuse of saving humanity. Did the Plutonian found out his atrocities, and that is why he was the first to be killed? For when he was about to be killed, he activated the Vesper protocol, which sent a signal to the Vesper soldiers. Cupid was livid with the Hornet for his deception, for he sacrificed hundreds of Earth-like planets due to his paranoia and selfishness. Now, the watch on Cupid's wrist began to trigger an alert, which was a signal that the Vesper soldiers had arrived. As the Plutonian tried to ignite and trigger the Sapphire of Ishwa, he was struck from behind by the Vesper soldiers as he passed out on the floor, captured and subjugated.